3 years after the Marawi siege, the Philippine Congress has passed a bill granting sweeping powers to law enforcers against terrorism. But given the country's long and brutal experience with violent extremists, why the public outrage over something that's supposed to help the common good? As they say, the devil is in the details. The Anti-Terrorism Act of 2020 adds muscle to the Human Security Act of 2007, which has been described as outdated and ineffective against today's terrorists. A terrorist is now someone who engages in acts such as those intended to cause death or serious bodily injury to any person or endangers a person's life. Someone who causes extensive damage or destruction to a government or public facility, a public place or private property. Someone who causes extensive interference with, damage or destruction to critical infrastructure. Such acts should be intended, for instance, to create an atmosphere or spread a message of fear, provoke or influence a government by intimidation, or seriously destabilize or destroy the fundamental political, economic, or social structures of the country. To human rights groups and lawyers, the definition is so vague that it could be used to target legitimate dissent. Worse, the approved bill includes inciting to commit terrorism, raising fears that it might be misused, like how the government has resorted to charging certain people with inciting to sedition. The new bill expands the powers of the Anti-Terrorism Council, a group composed of cabinet officials. It will have the power to designate and order the arrest and detention of suspected terrorists. These suspects may be detained for a period of 14 days without warrant and may remain in jail for another 10 days. Courts can also prescribe them initially as terrorists, keeping them in prison for up to 6 months while freezing their assets. During this period, the court will conduct hearings to decide if the preliminary prescription order will be made permanent. The new bill removes a crucial safeguard contained in the old law against government abuse. A hefty fine of 500,000 pesos for each day that a suspected terrorist was kept in jail but was eventually acquitted. Of course, the bill also includes safeguards against state abuse. But given this government's track record against its critics, they fear the safeguards are mere guarantees on paper. Christian Esguerra, ABS-CBN News.